Have you ever wondered why some people work so hard but still remain unsuccessful? Why others work less harder but become more successful? What makes the difference? Is it in their level of education? Is it the types of schools they attended? Does it depend on the homes they come from or the type of parents they have or where they were born? None of the above answers is correct. The secret is in the book called Secrets of the Millionaire Mind. I used to be very poor, struggling financially, going from door to door selling, and people don't want to buy. But the day I discovered this secret from this book and I implemented it, my life changed. And today, I moved from being poor and struggling financially to a life of business opportunities and financial prosperity where people run after me for my services and not me running after them and they don't want to buy. And in this video, I will share with you this particular secret. If you are new here, subscribe to this channel and turn on the notification bell and like this video as I continue to share with you the secrets of success from the world's most successful people. Okay, so let's move into the details. T. Harv Eker, the author of the book, says that the world we live in is made up of four dimensions. We have the physical world, we have the mental world, we have the emotional world, and we have the spiritual world. Now, the average person knows about the physical and only understands more about how the physical world, but they don't know how the mental, the emotional, and the spiritual world works. And what the author wants you to understand is that the physical world is just the result of the mental, the emotional, and the spiritual world. These things come together to produce this. So if you want to change anything here, you cannot change it by working on it here. You must work on the root. For example, whatever fruit you are reaping today, or whatever fruit you are reaping, depends on what you sowed. So in other words, every effect has a cause. So everything you see here is caused by something here. For example, let's say that you printed a certain document and you saw a mistake or a typo, and you went, you took your eraser and quickly erased the thing on the paper and printed another copy. You printed it and again the error was there again. If you don't work out on the computer and change what you have programmed, then you will continue to have the same result. So today I'm going to show you how to change the cause in order to get a different effect. So let's understand how this works. Each of us, or whoever we are, has something we call mental programming. The mental programming is what we have been conditioned to think. It's what controls everything that we do. So, whatever that you have been programmed to think, that produces your thoughts, or that controls how you think. So how you think leads to your feelings, and your feelings leads to your actions, and your actions leads to your results. So if you continue to work hard here, this is the results you continue to have. Before you can change this results, you must work on this. So let's go about it. Now let's say that you are currently making $10,000 a year and you want to make $100,000 by the end of the year. Your mind cannot handle $100,000 if you first of all does not change the content of these three. So how do we change it? Have you realized that most lotto winners, they will win huge sums of money, and within a short time, they lose everything. It is because they have not prepared this particular part. Anyone who says, oh, I'm looking for money to do this business, I want money to do this, or if I had got money, I would have been able to do this. Give them the money. If they don't have the correct mental capacity to hold that money will go. That is why a certain rich man once said that, if you gather all the monies in the whole world, everyone, the rich and the poor, you gather all their monies together and share it equally among everyone, it will soon return to the big man's pockets. or the rich people's pocket. That's what I mean. Now, what does that mean? It means that your ability to be rich is rooted in your subconscious mind, your mental beliefs, your mental programming. So if you want to change this particular resource, you have to change this. So what you need to change is the programming. So this is the original equation. So in order to change what is here, you must change down here. And how do you change it? You change it by programming your money blueprint. That is what T.H. Eckers calls it, your money blueprint. So what you do is that you have to change your programming. You change your programming by changing your beliefs, changing your expectations, reading the right books that will give you the right mindset. A lot of people come to me and I tell them, please, if you want to do this and that, go and read this book. And unfortunately, most of them will never read the books I recommend to them. And their problem is that they want an immediate solution, and I'm asking them to go and read the book. Let me tell you, the truth is that most of the time, until the content of your subconscious mind changes, you will never get the results that you're looking for. And this is from experience. I used to try so hard, work so hard. It is not about working hard. It is about working strategically hard. That is why in Africa, in the whole world, Africa has the people who really work hard physically. But it is the continent that has the poorest people. So it is not about working physically hard. It's about working mentally hard. So that is why you need to change the content of your subconscious mind. So how do you do? You do that by reading the right books, having the right mindset. For example, if you don't understand that in order to really become financially free, you must be able to identify problems, design a solution, learn how to scale. If you are not able to understand these things and you don't develop a particular idea or a skill that can solve particular problems and you can scale that particular solution to reach many people, then you may be working so hard, but you may not achieve what you want to do. So in order to change your subconscious, to change your results, you must first change the root, change whatever are in your subconscious mind, the beliefs that you have, by reading books that will actually help to develop the right mindset. So I will recommend you get a copy of this book called Secrets of the Millionaire Mind. Read it, read a lot of other personal development books. Focus your mind on the goals you want to achieve and work on it until it becomes part of your daily life and your habits. It is when it becomes part of your life and your habits that you do it unconsciously. And that is the time that you get the results without even struggle. And it is the truth and from real life experience. As I told you, I used to work so hard and the results were not coming. When I changed my mind and I understood this secret and I read more books, it came to a time that I don't need to work hard. The results were coming. Even when I am even having a lot of opportunities, people still call. I still get a lot of opportunities coming from all angles. So you need to understand this secret and it will help you. Thank you so much for watching.